West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider, no you don't want nada.
Daddy needs baby, won't you please come home?
The Wild Wild West.
You said you wanted me fired up, dude, so I'm fired up.
I do nothing but defend
filters
you.
Filters off.
I defend you all the time.
Hey, we're here live. Welcome to the podcast. We're here with the Joey Derosas.
Oh, my God.
Joey.
What's up, dude?
Why are you fucking being nasty?
You asked me to be. You said you didn't like when I came in polite today.
You weren't, yeah.
And you were polite. You were like, I want you more wound up. And you started talking to me about the state of comedy. And now I'm all fucking aggravated. Because I hate almost every one of our friends. And I can't tell them to their face.
Yeah, I know. I know. You can't.
You can't.
How could you?
You can't have friends, can't have enemies. You just got to pretend that everything is fine. It's the word.
Matt's back. Matt's back.
I was out there. I got a taste of the road.
Matt's back, dude.
I got a stomach
You're
virus.
You're back from the road?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
It was a week. That was enough for me. That was plenty.
You all right, though?
It was fun. Yeah, it was a good time. I got a stomach virus the very first night, so that was terrible.
Classic road.
Stomach virus, just dude.
Go out and get I've had a stomach virus ill.
Since I was like six, dude.
Yeah, that sucks. I've had the flu on the road. It's brutal. Like, I've been in a hotel in like fucking Massachusetts, shaking. Like, it's brutal, you know?
It's pretty funny.
Yeah. I thought I had food poisoning. So I was on the flight and I was like, man, it's cold on this fucking flight. I was like, I got the chills. I was like, shit.
When you got to fly with the sickness, it's the worst.
Dude, I was watching people order like shit at the airport, like coffees and baguettes and just being a little bagels or whatever, and just being like, yeah, you think you're fucking cool with the stomach, dude. Your stomach works and you think you're the man drinking coffee. Yeah. I'd die right now if I drank coffee. Oh. But it was cool. I understand the pressures to sell tickets are an immense pressure. I didn't like that at all.
It is. It's very uncomfortable.
I bother managers, dude. I'm like,
Where are we at?
Who cares? It's going to be good. I'm like,
Were you doing clubs?
Yeah.
Let me tell you what that is. They don't do a fucking goddamn thing to publicize their own shows.
Yeah,
and
true.
Then when nobody's there, they go, what is ticket sale? I wonder why. Really? That 6 minute spot on the weather fucking channel you had me do this morning didn't move tickets?
You got to do the clips, bro.
It's not every club.
You got to do crowd work clips.
Yeah, exactly.
I'd love it. I'd love to see Derosa's crowd work clips.
What's that? Shut up. You know, that's a problem these days. Everyone's a fucking bitch.
I yelled at a guy at a show recently. I was trying to talk to him. He wouldn't respond. And I go, relax. I'm not going to clip it and put it on the internet like every other fucking comedian in this country. You just talk to me.
Yeah.
No, it's not every club, but a lot of these clubs, like, they don't do anything to publicize, and then they sit there and go, what did you do? It's like, what did I do?
Well, I was waiting. That's what I was waiting for, like, the worst possible. They turned out good, but I was, like, ready for, like, the club to call me and be like, what the fuck did you do? And
well,
like,
then maybe it was.
Oh, I don't know.
It's worse.
What happens now?
I know we're doing stand-up comedy inside baseball shit, but.
Yeah.
There's not, like, you go from being a feature, which is the shit. You just show up. You're like, who gives a fuck who's here? This will be fun. I'm going to fuck around. I did 20 minutes. This is going to be great. The first time you start headlining, you're just like peeking your head out from behind the green room door.
It's
just
brutal.
Like, it's fucking empty.
I know.
It's fucking empty. What do we do?
Are you going to see people? Like,
I guess there's traffic. There might be traffic. And then you fucking ask the club owner and they're like, what's it looking like? They're like, tonight's not bad. Saturday night's looking pretty good. You're like, what the fuck?
Yeah. They love that.
So five shows are
Saturday
terrible?
Saturday is great early. I used to always make a joke when I went on the road because it was like every gig I would do, the club owner would come up to me and be like, and I'd be like, how are numbers? And they'd go, listen. It turns out The Beatles, they're not dead. They're alive. Yeah. And they're doing a reunion across the street.
I know this.
Always something. I swear to God,
it was
one time.
You recorded an album during the Final Four in Atlanta.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Yeah. I did a show on the Super Bowl.
I told you when the first time I ever met you was at the Lizard Lounge.
Yeah.
At the Chameleon Club in Lancaster.
Yes.
And I was
yes.
like, dude, that album fucking ruled.
Oh, thanks, man.
And that was exactly what you said then.
Oh, yeah. So it was a good bit for a little while.
And
there.
I was like, I love side B. The B side. Yeah, that
was. I wanted that to be the whole album. Was bombing at the.
It was my favorite.
Skull. Are you the B side bomb?
A side was the headlining, the real set, and then B side was the same set that he tried to do.
We tried Everyone to record at the Laughing Skull right during March. Awesome. What was it?
It's the Final Four.
Final
in Atlanta.
Four. It was in Atlanta. We tried to record the Laughing Skull. The shows were so bad and so poorly attended. Not because of the Laughing Skull. I like that place.
Yeah.
But because of just the circumstance.
Yeah.
And we got one show that I thought was worth something, and it was the crowd. It was the only packed show, and they were so drunk, and I fought with them the entire hour.
Yeah, it's awesome.
And I said, I want that to be the album. And this guy Jason, that has this label called Be Seen, did it. He was like, that you can't put that out. Like, that can be the second part.
Yeah.
So it was so rough of a run of shows. I left, went and did Moon Tower, and while I was at Moon Tower, what's his name? It was Mike Albanese and Gilbert, the two main, like, I feel like the main dudes of Atlanta comedy, called me and they're like, we can set up another show on Monday night because I was driving. And they're like, if you want to drive back through Atlanta on your way home, we can set up a show for Monday night at Star Bar and pack it. And we can try to record again. And I called the label guy and he's like, yeah. And we did it. We had one show. We got the album.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then that became the album. And then the B-side was the other thing. But it was always something like that. I remember being in North Carolina. They told me there was a fucking, I think it was called the Tulip Festival. And I was like, what? What is that? He was like,
Everyone's there.
He goes, you've heard of the flower, right? Yeah. And I was like, yes, I know the flower. He goes, there's a festival for it. And nobody's coming to the shows.
That's the thing. You go to Buffalo, you go to anywhere in the north. Yeah. If you go during the summer, they're like, yeah, people go outside.
Yeah.
We've been locked inside all winter, so you're not going to sell a ticket.
Yeah.
I did Indianapolis during the Final Four.
Which
in Indy, Helium. Okay. The whole crowd, the late shows, because everybody's just day drinking the whole time.
Oh.
It's just everybody's in like different college uniforms, shit face. They have no idea what the show is. They just came in. They're like, let's see some comedy tonight.
That just sucks.
Ugh.
That sucks.
Yeah, it does suck.
I had an office party in Phoenix. There was just like
nine people came up afterwards
and were like, that was interesting.
Yeah.
And I came up and was like, thanks, guys.
I got hit with an office party in Irvine. Two women. It was a holiday party. It was during Christmas.
Yeah.
A lady just sat like this, because you know how the tables are going that way?
Yeah, yeah.
They didn't face me. They faced each other and just
the whole
fucking show. There was an old woman going,
dude, can I tell you that I tried to do like the ultimate road dog move and invite a dude on stage with me and it backfired?
Of course it backfired. Why'd you do that?
He just yelled at me the whole time.
So funny.
Oh, what happened?
He was huge.
What happened when
he got
up there?
He just was talking the whole time. Like, dude, please stop. And he started like chattering. I'm like, yeah, why don't you get up here, dude?
Yeah, it's not as easy as it looks, asshole.
And he came up and was like, I was making fun of him, but it was insane. There's a drunk guy screaming on stage. I'd be like, okay, dude, get down. You got to get down now. The whole crowd was like, what is this? It looks so cool on YouTube, dude.
Yeah, it's so cool when they do it.
So funny. I was at Laugh Bar.
I was just scared. He was going to beat me up. I was like, oh, dude, you should get down now.
It would have been awesome if he would have fucking whooped your ass up there.
It would have been righteous.
That would have been a good clip.
I was like, dude, he's making fun of how I was dressed. I was like, dude, you're dressed like a Russian Uber driver, dude. Get out of here. He was like, you're fucking gay, dude.
The counter.
Yeah, I was like,
the perfect counter punch.
So what if I am, dude? Get this guy out of here.
Should have sucked his dick while I beat you up.
I would have won.
Yeah.
Him just punching you while you suck it has his dick in your mouth.
That would have been awesome, dude. Dude, that would have ruled.
Yeah.
From a ticket moving perspective, dude, that would have said
he was gay.
True.
Being like, he's just raining and boast.
We're not talking about stuff like that.
No, I did a Laugh Boston once, and I walked. There were 40 veterinarians there, and I walked.
Why?
I walked all of them. I was at the time I was doing a lot of
jokes about death, like dying and stuff. And this lady goes, it was a Christmas. It was their Christmas party, I guess. And she goes, change the subject. And I was like, well, what? And I got fucking pissed and I started talking to her and I was like, what do you do? And she was like, I work at the vet. And I go, but what do you do? And she goes, I massage the dogs before the operations.
Oh.
And I go, do you get extra for the hand job? And they all got up and left and then sent letters to the club and said, your comedian insinuated that my assistant sexually manipulates animals.
That is part of the job. Dude, they pop anal glands and stuff.
Yeah.
They do. Yeah, dude. A dog gets their anal glands
their
get
anal
fucking
glands get swollen.
Lemaire, shut him up, dude.
Oh yeah. Why don't you explain the
Yeah, Lemaire's Sean's boss now.
Tell you this though. Hold on.
This is very important to this is important part of canon.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, we hired Sean's our producer, but we hired Lemaire. We had fired Lemaire traditionally.
Yes.
I got fired.
Lemaire was our original producer?
Because one time he was original producer.
He was just unbelievably badass.
Yeah, he just fucked up constantly. We had someone sat out of frame for an entire
he deleted an episode. He would eat on camera. You'd hear him fucking crackling. He'd be high as shit. All of a sudden, you'd hear a bag of chips start to open. It was usually during a lull where we had nothing to say. There's some chips, so we were both like, fuck him. It's his fault.
That's funny.
So,
we fired him. And it, by the way, took the firing like a champ.
Like a fucking champ.
He was just like, oh, yeah, I get it.
Why are you acting like you got fired? Why are you talking like you got fired from Microsoft or something? You got fired from this. Who cares?
No, I know, but I'm saying we're friends. Right? So it was weird to
and
be
it was
like,
before the pod was big, right?
Right when it was starting
he
to
get he was like, you're doing me a favor, dude. Come sit
Fortune,
and watch you guys.
It was Fortune 300 at
now,
the time.
Yeah.
Fortune 300?
Now it's Fortune 5.
All right. You guys are doing real well. I see the charts. I do. I see the charts.
Which one, bar or this one?
Which one? The one that we're number one on?
I see chartable. I don't care for it.
Shut up over there.
This show's always
above.
This
isn't your mom's house.
This is no, I'm serious. You guys chart well. I'm not being funny.
Which
chart
are you referring to? We didn't, Lemaire, look up the charts.
If you go to Chartable, Chartable is a website and it shows you like the Apple rankings.
Gotcha.
And you guys consistently are above my podcast and it bothers me.
Why?
We don't look at that. You got to stop looking at that.
Yeah,
stuff,
we don't look at the charts. We look at the money charts.
Yeah, that's what I look at, dude. Let's talk about it. You saw what I'm wrong with today, right?
Oh, I saw you in there almost.
Whoa, dude. What the fuck are you doing?
I don't want to. That's $100.
Big blue faces, bro.
Yeah.
Folks, that's $100.
Yeah, that's $100. There's folks. A 20 under it, too.
Folks.
That's my favorite thing you do.
The folks joke?
Folks.
I don't really do
it. He'll tell like a stupid joke, and then to end it, you just, folks. Let me hear one. I know you got one loaded.
The one I used to do to the on stage, I would do it. You know Blake Wexler?
Yeah.
All right. I have a funny Blake Wexler thing that relates to this, but I would find a fat guy. I go, hey, buddy, you could be a runway model at LAX. You know, because he's fat.
Yeah.
Get it? And then I go, folks, you know? And then I'd find a lady with huge tits, and I'd go, lady, is that a boob job? Looks like your doctor was working overtime. Listen, folks. It was bad on purpose.
Folks is great.
But I did that at a show that Blake Wexler had, and I did the runway, and dude, it like bombed. Like, they didn't get the irony of it or anything. The guy just thought I was being mean.
Yeah.
And I got off stage, and Blake Wexler was laughing so hard. He goes, my favorite part of the show is when you called that guy a fat pig.
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't like fat talk anymore. You can't
that
do
that. Real. Wow, you're like, you said that like you hate Blake. You're like,
I love Blake. Yeah. I was just gonna start complimenting Blake, and then I was like, that's kind of fucking gay of me.
He's shooting a special this weekend.
Oh, really?
Yeah, in Cleveland, yeah.
Blake's the man. I ran into him on the way into the NFC Championship game in Philly.
He's the man, dude.
Yeah.
He's like the nicest. He's funny as shit, too. Yeah. He really makes me fucking laugh.
Is he still working with Todd Glass a lot? Todd Glass posts the funniest fucking social media
Todd's
shit.
So funny, man.
What does he do?
He posts like weird videos where he's like the Uber driver and somebody else is filming. He's like, our Uber driver's crazy. And he's just up there ranting. He's so good at like actually being that guy.
Todd's the best guy ever.
He's got a little Mel Gibson in him. Todd Glass is a little Mel. You know what I'm saying?
Speaking of Mel, dude, I just watched Braveheart.
Wait, let's talk about Todd Glass bits first.
Now, hold on. Let's talk about Mel. Let's talk about Braveheart, dude.
Yeah, Gibson.
Come on.
This is how you get the ticker.
Oh, yeah.
Up.
He's got movie takes. He's a big movie snob.
A bit of
I'm not a snob at all.
You're a bit of a cinephile.
A cinephile.
Foodie. Your Twitter bio should be foodie/cinephile.
Foodie? You shouldn't be comedian?
Well, then, obviously.
No. Yeah, no, you have a point.
What
I'm
about
sorry.
A feeble, what about a feebophile?
What did you
call it? You a feebophile?
What's a feumophile?
A feebophile is like a cool pedophile. It's like the guys who are like only like 16, 17.
Yeah. Beasts.
I used to say D'Elia. You know, folks. There you go. That's a good folks. Sure. Yeah, yeah.
What do you think about Mel Gibson?
I'm a fan.
All right.
I mean, he had a slip up.
About what?
He had a slip up.
Wait, are you talking about Daddy's Home, too?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wasn't that like his first one back? Was like Daddy's Home? Daddy's Home.
No, his first one back was The Beaver. Here, brother. The Beavers with Jodie Foster directed it.
I've never even
heard
of it.
What was the movie about?
It was a movie about a guy who had a mental, like he was in therapy and he started to carry a puppet around of a beaver. I think that he would like speak through.
What? That was his first one back?
Yeah, it was like an art house kind of thing that Jodie Foster did. But he did that like, I'm talking like.
Right.
I was like, damn, Jodie Foster's a G. Like, she stepped right in like nice. A month later, was like, I'm gonna get you back on your feet, pal. You know, like I was like, God damn, I don't even think he paid the ticket yet for when he called the cop a Jew or whatever the fuck he said.
He got busted for everything. I think he gets that like he just nuked everything so hard that it was like just let him right back in.
Yeah.
It's so he did everything. He hit every button you could possibly.
You know what I saw last night or yesterday?
Yeah.
That was Ray Liotta's final movie, Cocaine Bear.
Oh, was it good?
No.
I heard it was kind of fun and crazy. It's not?
It's kind of fun and crazy, but it's bad. It's got a lot, like half the jokes are like, if a little kid says fuck.
Oh, I hate that.
It bothers me so much. I saw it in theater, and there were people howling laughing, which actually made me start to laugh, because this one lady got the giggles. She couldn't stop laughing, and then I started. I was like, first I was like, fucking retards think this is funny, and then she kept laughing. I was like, fuck, that's pretty funny. She's funny. Yeah, the whole movie's, it's crud. Yeah.
How's Liotta in it?
He's actually pretty good, but it's a bummer that that's his.
I feel like Liotta.
It's his last movie.
Liotta was on.
It's kind of a good way to go, though. He gets fucking killed by a bear.
He was on autopilot. Pretty sweet. I feel like the last 10 years he was really on autopilot.
He was doing fucking.
What am I doing? Playing a crazy cocaine? Okay. You know, like every movie.
What did he do besides Goodfellas? I don't even know what movies he was in.
He's in shitloads.
Really?
Was it shitloads. Field of Dreams?
What?
He was in Field of Dreams, small part.
Briefly,
Copland. He's great in Copland. He's a great actor. Something Wild was his big breakthrough.
Yeah.
Jonathan Demme movie. He's great. He's great. He was a great actor, and he was great at playing a guy that, like an intense kid. He played Sinatra in the Rat Pack. He was awesome.
What?
He's a great actor. But then this last 10 years, I felt like he just was like, fuck it, man. I'm working. I'm not going to question it.
Chantix.
Samuel Jackson.
Yeah. Like, it's like they bring Samuel Jackson in to be Samuel Jackson now. You know what I mean?
What do you think about, What do you think about Frank Sinatra? Like him? Love him?
Love
think
him.
He's overrated?
Love
really?
Him. First concert I ever saw was Frank Sinatra.
Really? I have a non-popular take on Frank Sinatra. Glorified karaoke singer. That's what I think.
Wops love him. You gotta watch out.
What is glorified, that based in?
Just the way I hear opinion. It. I could literally do all of his songs probably better.
No, this is what I've heard this opinion before, and I wanna congratulate you for being on the intelligence level of Big J Okerson, who's the other person that expressed this to me, that crooning was easy and anybody could do it.
You ever been to an Italian wedding? Every Italian dad croons at their daughter's wedding.
They croon to say goodbye. They say they know their baby girl's going to get fucking,
I will tell you this.
She's going to get plugged tonight, so I got to sing.
It's like that take on.
I would croon if a guy picked up, I came to my house to pick up one of my sisters to go on a date. I would croon. I was younger. I was 6 years younger, but I would still croon.
That's funny.
I go, tonight is the night.
That's funny.
You're going to finger my sister.
Did she get mad?
Oh, they'd get mad, especially the black ones.
Yeah.
Me and my dad would croon.
That's so funny.
We saw a black guy come to pick up our sister. Or, you know.
That's so funny.
Don't call the cops on that Denali. There's a Denali in this town.
That's so
got
funny.
Got the neighbors talking.
But that take on crooning, let me bring it back down.
Take it back down.
I like to take podcasts. I like to go on podcasts that are jovial and laughter filled sure. and talk serious.
For
them.
Sure.
I derailed Hey Babe last time I was on. Nice. Talked about depression for 45 minutes.
That's what you got to do.
Anyway, but no, that take on crooning is this. I understand why people say it, but it's like saying. It's like saying B.B. King is talentless. I could play a blues riff, and it's like, well, you could, but you couldn't play it.
Most you know people I mean? Can't play.
Like you
talking about the pentatonic minor. Like most people can't play the B.B. King. Yeah.
Like I think
that's
if you,
more talent than
I think if Frank you watched Sinatra. Blues yeah. music and you yeah. watched traditional blues music
for sure,
outside of the guitar solos, mm-hmm. you would go. An amateur person would go, I could do that.
40 times better than Frank
Punk
Sinatra.
Rock, they would say it about, you know.
Nah, you gotta
oh,
have.
It's three chords. It's this, that. Sinatra, dude, the emotion, the...
There's no emotion.
You're really wrong.
I disagree. I don't know
what you're talking
that.
About.
Towards the end? No. Dude, I'll say this, too. I thought Elvis sucked forever. And then I saw that last, his fat fucking
it's amazing.
Fat singing.
It's amazing.
Have you
fat
seen
Elvis?
Fat singing?
I've never seen
yeah,
it,
it's
no.
amazing.
Dude, we might need to pause this so you can
watch
see
him fat Elvis.
Singing
I want
to
see fat Elvis.
Dude,
it's
that thing.
Unbelievably good. What's the song yeah. he sings that's
that Unchained Melody thing?
Unchained Melody.
At the end of the yeah, movie, yeah, I was crying my fucking eyes out.
Oh, you watched the whole movie?
I watched it with my parents. I had to hide that I was crying the whole time.
That movie sucked dick,
it was
dude.
Awesome. That movie was awesome.
So what do you think is better, Frank Sinatra or Enya?
I can't speak to Enya. I don't know anything.
Enya's
about
an Irish
her.
That's real Irish
no,
musician.
No, I know who she is. I just
real
don't
musician.
Know.
She's literally worth more than Chris Martin from Coldplay.
Okay.
She lives in a castle next to Bono.
Okay.
That's feeling in that no, movie. No. Frank, I've never felt I listen to Frank Sinatra, I don't feel anything, man. I listen to him, I go, what the hell is well, this old you, fucking but, dumbass rattling on about?
He's an old dumb wop, dude. And also,
Enya is ethereal, dude.
Enya is so good.
Dude.
Enya, I cried at the end of Enya.
Oh, it's beautiful.
No, you didn't.
Shut dude, up. She lives, she's one of the most, she's one of the richest UK recording
artists. That must mean she's good.
I mean, dude,
if
she never tours. She doesn't tour at all.
Yeah.
She doesn't tour at all.
Why do you know so much about Enya, you fucking queef?
She's so good, dude.
Point Derosa. Unfortunately, Point Derosa.
I just researched this yesterday on YouTube.
I just
researched this yesterday. I was curious about Enya. You always
Damn,
hear
I just
so much
watch
about
Enya.
My dad liked Enya. My dad got into new age music when he I was knows. Younger, and he was into, he loved Enya, and he bought the single for that. What the, was that band, Sadness Part 1? Boop, 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 boop. It was like that.
I like that.
That
Keep
instrumental
going.
Song. No, you remember that song? It was called Sadness Part. Can somebody...
No, I don't
Google
know how
it.
Hear it.
The song Sadness Part 1, I forget. Enigma, I think, was the name of the band.
Ooh, that yeah, sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah, my dad got an NXS for a while. I kind
Enigma?
Of enjoyed that.
Yeah. And it was like, it was kind of like when, it was like when, remember when Back to Life came out, Soul to Soul? Back to life, back
to reality. Reality.
There was
back
like that phase life. Of music in the very early 90s where it was like instrumental, but it was... Sort of got the song still got big.
Yeah, it was that song, that album I was talking about that I was listening to. What was that gay album I found? Whatever, it was just early 90s, late, all those gay songs. I liked them.
Yeah,
anyway, I thought somebody would remember what it was. I couldn't.
What's on your hat, man?
It's our cool logo
branding.
SODATIGE.
Yep,
what's that say?
SODATIGE.
No, seriously, what's it say? Sod. I can't see what it says. What does it say?
What's that?
What is the word on your hat?
What's that, sir? You don't think
is
I can get out of this?
No,
I feel like
gag?
I tanked the vibe. It's not your comment. I was just messing around.
I don't think it's
the best.
I've been going around saying Prince sucks.
True.
Wait, what does his hat say?
So it's
whatever you tell him. Don't tell him ever. God damn it.
SODATIGE.
SODATIGE?
SODATIGE.
SODATIGE. It's our company.
Oh, okay.
It's our LLC. SODATIGE.
Where'd you get that shirt from, dude?
I bought it off the internet. All right, cardigan, you fucking pussy. Clear glasses, cardigans, dude.
You better watch,
Chucks,
dude.
We cool be, socks. Shut up.
I'll we beat don't you have up to in your own apartment.
You literally look like a fucking, you look like a third
Whoa,
grade
what
teacher.
Were you just going to say, dude?
Nothing.
Dude, what were you just going to say?
That's for real. My third grade teacher's outfit. She was a woman.
Yeah.
She was a dumb woman.
Do you think I won't slap you on your own couch?
I'd love to beat the fuck out of you.
It's got to come to blows.
How do you do this?
It's got to come to blows.
You're so nasty.
It's got to come to blows.
Every time. And then he'll call me tomorrow.
Call me nasty.
Dude, when you said you were going to beat me up, that actually wasn't cool.
No, I would not say that. And you're always saying that because Soder said I would say that. What about the Super Bowl?
That's not true.
Huh?
I've had how many of those phone calls with you?
No, I never.
Where I go, my bad, I went too hard.
Oh, well.
You were right, my bad.
You, I didn't say when you said you were going to beat me up.
No, of course not that. I was exaggerating.
You had a couple times where you got like a little too.
I get it.
But it was like coming from a place of hurt in you.
Yeah, probably.
Which was interesting. It wasn't anger. It was like you would get hurt and then like keep pushing buttons.
Or is that just the real superpower?
You know?
Maybe.
You'd be, because you would tell me after, I don't think it's TMI, you'd tell me after, you'd be like, you know, dude, I just thought like, we were like boys, dude, and you like, we talked on the phone yesterday, and you show up, you don't even say hi to me.
Point
you
said that to me about
Ari. Wait a minute. That's exactly what you do. That's crazy.
No, you do it too.
Yeah, no, I go, my bad, you were hurt. I didn't know you were actually
hurt.
No,
but you got mad at me at Ari's picnic because I didn't say hi to you when I walked in. You were mad at me about that. It was also the same time you got mad at
dude, that sauce.
That was Pearl. That's a lie. Pearl Harbored him, dude. Yeah. It's about to be a dumb.
Here it comes.
No, that's also the night you got in the fight with what's his name? Because you almost pushed him off the roof.
Oh, me and O'Connor got in a battle.
Yeah, you were in a space that
why
day.
Why is it gotta be like this?
No, I was. I'll give you the credit that I was fucking with you too much. You were like, we were sitting outside, it was like sunny, we're on that small thing, and I kept fucking with you. And you were like, dude, enough. And I was like, all right.
Because I was like, I just want to hang out and have fun today.
I know.
Yeah,
I know.
We're not like.
I said sorry 2 years ago when that happened.
I'm not mad.
You're
about
a lady,
it.
Dude.
I ain't mad about it.
God.
I'm not mad about it.
You're telling me, between the two of us, when we talk shit, I'm not the one always calling to say sorry.
What do you mean always? I feel like we had this phone call two times. Once you called me and said, dude, I was being too much. And then there was another time I probably called you and said the same thing.
All right. Well, it's not a big deal.
You know? We had a very, but in all fairness to both of us, we had a very, we had a weirdly contentious period.
Yeah.
Where like when we would meet up,
two alphas,
when we were ready to be like, in fact, when we both did We Might Be Drunk last, I remember you were like, you going to be like this today, dude?
I say it every time. I go, let's not do it.
It's two alphas, dude.
Rather not do it.
But you
and
want
then there's
me,
one. Then there's one. You hit me with one. I go, all right, he did it. Everybody saw it. That
no,
was the first one.
You asked me to do it today.
No. Well, today we're having fun.
Yeah.
Today we're goofing. But if you do cross the line, I'll put you down.
Yeah. I feel like you guys want a connection. It's like, who was that old writer that said like humans are like porcupines in a cold night and they just want to get close to each other, but their spikes just fucking.
R.L. Stein.
All I heard was porky.
That's off fucking limits,
dude. I was trying to wind you up on the way over, dude. And I was like,
no, you couldn't.
I know, because he said he would pay for my Ubers. And I texted him and I go, I'm in the Uber. Have my fucking Uber money ready when I get there.
I said, screenshot the receipt.
Yeah. And I was like, come on, dude. And he's like, I know you want me to fight, but I'm not doing it.
I'm not going
to
fight you.
He wouldn't
no fight. Yeah, no fight. No, we were having a nice discussion.
Yeah, no. I was just fucking
fell apart.
Around. Hold on. Tell me if I'm wrong on this.
Yeah.
Prince sucks.
No, that's
overrated. Prince is overrated.
No, that's an insane.
It's insane.
Days pretty
the guy,
good.
The guy, like arguably the most talented musician that ever
hearing.
Lived.
That's what I keep hearing, and then I watch a song and I go, "Who's this?"
If you watch one of his performances, I didn't know he shred. I just didn't think anything of him. I saw him shred,
but I don't totally care about.
And he can
shredding.
Hit like he shreds, can sing dude. Like he can hit these notes that are like
he's
inhuman.
A total package.
I haven't watched enough.
Total package.
I keep saying, could somebody help me?
He also knows.
Everybody keeps telling me I'm wrong. All I'm looking for is one person to go, yeah, you're right.
I'll tell you this, buddy.
No, he's nice.
I'll tell you this with Prince. So Prince, like, you know, first of all, any guy that can put out like a double album of greatest hits and you know every song, like that's an impressive record. But I'll say this with Prince. He's such an artist. Like he's a guy that gets way up his own ass and he'll put out full records of things where you're like, what are you doing, man?
Yeah.
I couldn't, you know what I mean?
That's another thing. I couldn't name like
his songs.
Four songs.
Yeah.
You know.
I'm with you there. I don't know a lot of his songs, but I saw him perform one time and went, what the fuck? He was on TV. And I went, damn, this guy's nasty. He was
I'll
nasty.
Tell you who's kind of, and I respect the hell out of her. I really do, but.
Celine Dion?
True.
No, Celine? She's sick, man. Don't make fun of Celine.
Yeah, she's.
I feel bad for her.
She's sick?
Cramping up, yeah.
Yeah, she's got like.
She's getting stiff.
She's it sounds horrible. Like it's a really rare thing.
It's like living statue disease or something.
It's horrible.
I swear to God, that's what it's called.
But is it affecting her organs?
No, her, just her like, whole. She's gonna stop.
So her heart's gonna go on.
I think. Oh shit. Damn, dude. I didn't even catch that.
Folks.
She has a disease where one day she's going to go and stop in one pose. And that's that.
Ugh.
Her body.
It's a disease called stiff person syndrome.
Yep. Yo, I think I had that this morning, dude.
Yeah, bump it. Bump it. We're talking dicks. We're talking boners. Matt's talking boners.
I know. I love boner.
Speaking of boners, you were never mind.
Who's the
what? I was what?
I don't want to start. I was gonna start the attack.
No, go ahead.
No, we're having a nice time.
Who's the female artist? You stand by.
No, I was gonna say, like, I've always been a little underwhelmed with and I respect her so much, but I've always been a little underwhelmed with Madonna live.
Dude, don't get me started on Madonna shit right now.
You don't like Madonna?
I don't like what she's trying to like do. We are doing now? To her. She has to be hot now. She's 60, dude. Leave her alone.
Yeah.
She's 60. She's a rich 60-year-old.
It was like when I saw the fucking Rolling Stones.
True.
Mick's still up there shucking and jiving, trying to be sexy. It's kind of like, ew, dude.
That's my controversial one.
What?
You don't like Stones?
I hate the Rolling Stones.
That's a fair one, though.
Like, I find them grating and annoying. I hate them. And the Beatles, too. I find the Beatles, like, annoying.
No, the Beatles are good. I have two Beatles
albums. I would never own a Stones album, I don't think.
Yeah.
There are two Beatles records I like. What, dude? Beatles. Go ahead, say it, dude. Say it.
No. Wait, so you don't like Madonna that much?
No, this is... You're doing it without doing it. Yeah, just do it.
No, I'm not going to say it. It'll be too mean. I would devastate you. What, You'd be so mad, dude.
What's it about?
You'd go full mad
out. Just tell me category. Tell me the category.
Nothing.
Sexual impropriety.
Yeah. So you like Madonna more than the Beatles and the Rolling Stones?
I wouldn't say. Actually, yeah, I would listen to a Madonna greatest hits before I'd listen to a Beatles or Rolling Stones.
That's a fucking crazy take.
That's nuts.
It's not me saying I think they're bad bands. Yeah, yeah. I just don't like the music. Like, yeah. I find the Rolling Stones to just be. I can't put my finger on it. I just find it irritating.
You think they're for dumbasses?
And also, I'm just, yeah.
To be fair.
Yeah, for morons. Yeah. For cucks. You know what I mean? And the Beatles, if I just hear one more fucking guy in his 50s be like, fucking John Lennon, man. It's like, shut the fuck up. Discover a new band. They didn't do it first. The fucking Beach Boys did it first. They did it more interestingly. The Beatles were great at what they did. But it's like saying, and I love Nirvana, but it's like saying Nirvana created the thing. They didn't create the thing. Sonic Youth and the Melvins, there were other bands doing it before Nirvana. But Nirvana did it in a formula that caught.
And then killed themselves.
And I think they would even admit to that.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the Beatles, it's just like this. And it's weird. I love fucking Paul McCartney's solo stuff.
See, I'm the opposite. I'm a Lennon guy.
I think Lennon is garbage. And I do think he's way overrated.
Lennon?
Abso-fucking-lutely.
The whole band was fucking McCartney.
I think his solo stuff is so fucking boring.
Well, he made a wrong turn with the wife in the band.
Oh, my
Anyone
God.
Anyone could do that.
His millionaire bullshit. Go! I'm going to lay in a bed with my $1 billion and fight world hunger, whatever the fuck he did.
He was proto bono.
I'm not fighting anything. I do the exact same thing. That's like, I lay in bed for like 5 days at a time.
That's my favorite joke at Office Space. Where he goes... What'd you do if you had $1 million? I'd do nothing. I'd sit on my ass all day. Yeah. Well, damn. My cousin's broke. He don't do shit. You don't need $1 million to do that.
What a hit. What a smash hit movie.
That movie is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you see the documentary with the Beatles?
Which one?
The one that came out. It was like the big one.
No, the one,
like
that just
40
came,
hours. Yeah.
No. I wasn't. Yeah,
everyone swears by it.
Shines light on McCartney. McCartney was a bit of a... I mean, he was kind of the driving force of the band. Songwriting.
It's so obvious when you hear his solo shit, you're like, this guy like knows his way around music. Like,
yeah,
he fucks with different genres. He's got stuff that's like almost in, he's got stuff on McCartney too that almost sounds like Ween and shit like that. I'm like, this guy was like,
that's what I want,
you know, it's
more Ween.
Yeah, dude.
Like Ween.
You like Ween?
Kreischer took us when we did a show with him.
Kreischer took
no. He took. I was gonna make fun of him, but all right.
Oh no, go ahead. Go ahead. I love Kreischer. Yeah, he's fun to make fun of.
Took us to Wilco.
Wilco.
So they were the next night at the venue we did, and he was like, "This is my favorite band. We're gonna stay an extra day." I was like, "All right, I've never seen Wilco."
Dude, they started playing.
I never saw them. They started playing, and I was just like, "No way, dude!" We had to sit through a whole Wilco concert.
Yeah,
dude.
You like Wilco.
I like some of their songs, but I couldn't sit there.
He's got his leg ready to repel you.
No, it's like Dave. It would be like going to see Dave Matthews Band. I'd be like,
I would have loved to have seen DMB. I would have been
like,
dude,
all right, ants marching. I'm good. Yeah. Let's get out of here. But I'm like, yeah, I don't want to sit through the jam.
But also, I never heard one Wilco song.
That's the finger break.
So there was nothing.
That's fucking Bert's favorite band. It just doesn't fit his personality.
Yeah, you'd think it'd be like Van Halen.
Yeah, that's a perfect call, actually. Yeah. 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 Or like Motley Crue.
But it was very funny because he was into it. So I'm just sitting there like, oh, God. Dude, you suck.
And you got to sit there.
But I couldn't. You got to sit there and pretend. I couldn't be mean because he was genuinely happy.
Yeah.
He was genuinely happy, and he also gifted you this wonderful experience.
Yeah. Yeah.
You just had to be like, this is great.
Where do you see it? Was it? Weren't they at Red Rocks?
Yeah, it was at Red Rocks. It
probably was a decent con. I saw them open up for Neil Young. I didn't know who they were.
It was on Mushrooms, too, and it still was like, it was just a sea of fucking middle-aged white dudes.
See, that'll do it.
In fucking,
Patagonia. Patagonia.
Everyone just...
You're in Mumford.
Everyone trying to dance.
Oh, that'll hurt.
And then
you
would, on Mushrooms, you'd turn around and look up. There'd be a wall of white dudes going...
That's like Mumford's and Sons white. Yeah. That's Mumford's and Sons white.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Mumford and Sons rules.
I can't stand them. But my point is you're in the level.
I like their politics.
What are their politics?
I don't know. I think they got in trouble for something.
The one guy got kicked out of the band.
Did he really?
Because he kept it real.
Yeah, he kept it 100.
Kept it 100.
What are some of the other whitest bands? Wilco, Mumford & Sons.
Coldplay.
Yeah, Coldplay's got that universal appeal, though.
Coldplay's a little bit different because it's like...
You can get gay Argentinians.
Whitest bands?
I'll give you a great one.
Oh, you got death metal.
Yeah.
No. But that's not what I mean. I mean there's something like David Byrne's another one of these. There's white musicians.
McDonald.
That white
Michael McDonald.
That wealthy white liberal people love think they're still hip for
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And Wilco's definitely that.
Wilco.
Dave Matthews is definitely that.
Dave Matthews rules.
You know?
Dave Matthews is swag, dude.
Going to a Dave Matthews concert when you're in 10th grade.
I never got to go.
Shit, yeah, when there was only two albums before it all sucked. Yeah, I would have thought that was cool.
I didn't care about the music. It was just the first time I ever got to sneak a water bottle of vodka.
Hershey Park. He seems like the man.
Dave Matthews?
Yeah.
DMB.
Yeah.
He's got a thing about hunger. That's the one thing. The only time I saw him talk is when he was saying, man, we're starving. And he had all these African musicians with him. And he went, I guess I'm using that word wrong. I shouldn't use the word starving like that. And then I take it all back. And he wrote that song, Too Much.
I drink too much.
Smoke too much.
Because he went, man, I'm starving. I need to eat. There was African bass players. And he went,
that's a great song.
Yeah.
I always think I want to listen to Dave Matthews. And then I listen to it for one song. Later, and I'm like, fuck, this sucks. I'm always like, damn, I remember how much that was a fucking good
marching,
song.
Dude.
OAR. I used to love that song.
Yeah.
OAR was one when I was young.
Santa light in the sky like a diamond.
OAR was a spinoff Dave Matthews.
OAR fucking Dashboard Confessional.
That's where I
was gay. Dude, Dashboard was the gayest.
Fuck that. That dude with his acoustic guitar playing songs that are supposed to be electric, but they're not.
Yeah.
Yeah, that sucked. Wait,
but I was a young man tapped into my wild emotions.
There's one Dave Matthews song I still love. It's the first song on the second album. What's the second album called?
I don't know.
What about Crash?
Under the
table second album
fapping?
Is called Crash.
No, is it?
The second album is called Crash. The first song on it.
You can do it. I'll get it.
I don't know.
It's called Too Much to Say, Too Much to Say. That song's awesome.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Guys, it's time to talk Athletic Greens. Joe, it's time.
Nice.
Sometimes it's about the art. I gave AG1 a try because I wanted a supplement that actually tasted great, would be an easy addition to my already rigorous health lifestyle. If you hate taking pills, this once-a-day drink is perfect. How does AGI1 make me feel? I think it does make me feel good. I drink it. I go, I'm done for the day.
It makes me feel like I'm taking pills, actually.
Yeah, it makes me feel fucked up. I take it and I go, mission accomplished. That's, I'm healthy.
Oh, yeah.
Here's to getting shredded. AG1, 75 vitamins, minerals, and whole food sourced ingredients are helping me look like a Greek god. Did they write this literally making fun of me?
They might have.
I think they wrote this to make fun of me. Okay. Okay. What the fuck? No, Greek god, yeah. Dionysus. If you're looking for an easier way to take supplements, Athletic Greens, yeah, I'm very buxom. Athletic Greens is giving you a free 1-year supply of vitamin D and 5 travel packs with your first purchase. Go to athleticgreens.com/drench. That's athleticgreens.com/drench. Check it out, Joe DeRosa.
Today's episode is brought to you by Hamilton Devices.
Yes.
Their vapes are next level. We've been loving the Starship with 3 heating elements inside. It will take your high out of this world. Another favorite of mine is the Gamer, a hands-free way to vape on the go. Guys, I don't even need to talk these vapes up. The vapes fucking vape for themselves, guys. With huge clouds, full flavor, and thick oils, get ready for an incredible high. Hamilton Devices is hooking our listeners up. Go to hamiltondevices.com and use code DRENCHED15 for 15% off. Buyers must be 21 or older. That's hamiltondevices.com, code DRENCHED15 for 15% off.
Thank you, Matt. Now let's get back to the show.
Joe,
how do you feel about comedy?
We'll both do Rex MD at the same time.
All right. Yeah. Are you ready?
Yep. Picture it.
You met a honey.
Brought her home.
Brought her home. And now things just aren't happening.
Yeah. This is where Rex MD comes in. They make getting generic and branded Viagra or Cialis quick and easy.
And completely, online.
Talk about a time Rex MD would have helped.
It would have helped?
Yeah, talk about a time. When was the time? Can you share a very embarrassing sexual memory of yours?
I'd say 50% of the time I could have used Rex MD.
You drink too much and your penis doesn't work.
Yeah, that's...
Did you Google it?
Yeah, obesity has a little to do with it, too.
No insurance, no copays, and it's delivered discreetly to your door.
Not just ED medication, Rex MD's other medications help sexual health, hair growth, pain relief, and sleep aid.
God damn.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
What the fuck?
Act now to take advantage of their best deal yet by heading to rexmd.com/drenched.
Our exclusive deal will save you up to 90% off, so you're only going to pay $2 per dosage. What else, Matt?
Starter packs of generic Viagra or Cialis are now available for our listeners to get started.
That's rexmd.com/drench for up to 90% off.
Give the gift of pleasure this year with Rex MD.
Thank you.
Fantastic, dude.
Shut up. Please come to my show at the Stand March 1, Wednesday this coming week. Thank you. Goodbye. This is Shawn Gardini.
Still rules. You can get pussy at a Dave Matthews Band concert still.
So. Dude, hairy, unkept pussy.
Yeah, now it is. It was the best of the best.
Back in the day, it was the finest. It was like the weed smoking sluts.
The bad girls.
It was when hippies were hot. It was like when there was a version of hippie that was hot.
Yeah.
Dude, I still have it in me. I hate hippies. I'm watching that fucking, it's in there.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know where it came from. It's instilled. I'm watching the Vietnam Ken Burns thing.
You can't stand
anytime
them.
They show the hippies, I'm like, these fucking dickheads. By the way, they're completely right. They're like, this war is wrong. They're totally right. Yeah. I'm sitting there like, shut up. There's guys over there dying.
But they stunk. They had their own problems, though. Then they went and did these communes and like molested each other.
Yeah.
But it's the same reason why you hate most hipsters. It's like it's the same thing. It's like the right concept, and it's executed in entirely the wrong way, and it's annoying and bratty, and it's kids whose parents are paying for them to have the privilege to go sit. It's the epitome of white privilege, and yet it's the main mouthpiece against white privilege.
Yeah.
And it's just so insane and hypocritical. It's hard to stomach. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's too much.
Too much.
Dave, too much. Rules, dude. We love you, Dave.
All right, I changed my mind. I'm sorry I said it all sucked after the second
album.
Come on,
dude. He's got some hits. He's got more hits than Prince, dude. Significantly more hits.
I also still like...
Check the billboards. I don't know enough of Prince's music. I really don't. I gotta saw listen him shred.
But again, it only takes one song. I thought Elvis sucked dick. Then I watched Unchained, Fat Elvis Unchained.
Hound Dog's nice.
Hound Dog's fucking rules. Nice.
You guys, the first Elvis album is awesome. The very first one?
I don't know.
The self-titled? That album is awesome.
What about Lil' Red Corvette, Raspberry Beret?
Exactly.
Come on, dude.
What's all that, Prince?
Yeah. Dude. Prince is nice.
How's sing Raspberry Beret.
Raspberry Beret.
Banana.
She's the
kind you find at a secondhand store.
Sounds like shit.
This song is awesome.
Truly, that sounds like.
Check top 100 hits. We'll check top 100's DMB versus Prince. We'll settle it all.
Top 100 is gonna be tough for DMB, I think.
Really? Fucking Ants Marching.
Oh, dude, Dave Matthews is a
Crash.
Prince, what are you nuts?
We'll see. I guess.
After the third album.
I like the one Prince song from Batman.
What song was that?
Bat Dance.
That shit ruled, whatever that was. when the Joker, when Jack Nicholson
Bat
comes
dance.
In.
That's Bat Dance.
Awesome.
That fucking rules.
I'll give him that.
Yeah, I mean,
there's some guys that have some hits in movies. Fucking Vanilla Ice and Ninja Turtles.
Dude, go Ninja
what
Go.
What a fucking jam, dude. I remember being a kid, just.
Yeah, dude. How bad did you want to do the fucking Michelangelo spin on your like shell?
I remember I was so
mad.
How many
brush burns I got trying that in the basement?
I was so mad at Ninja Turtles 2.
Yeah.
For two reasons. I loved the
was
first.
Was that the one that came out recently?
No. Like the one that had the ninja rap or whatever.
Wait, how old were you when this came out?
12.
And you were still a little, you were critical, you were a critic back then? You're a punk,
no,
dude.
No, because I loved the first one.
For sure.
And I loved Turtle Power, the rap song.
Yeah.
And then the second inspiring. One came out, and the second one looked so shitty, even in the trailers as a kid. I was like, this looks terrible. And then the rap song was Vanilla
go
Ice.
Ninja Go?
It was
go
like
ninja,
Downslide
ninja,
Vanilla
go.
Ice.
What? Go Ninja, go Ninja.
Oh, I was
that
so
was
mad.
His comeback.
That was a fucking great song.
That was his fucking comeback.
You can't
comeback.
Take that away.
He went out on a fucking Grand Slam home run. Everyone's like, all right, Vanilla. All right, Ice, you did it, dude.
Yeah, you did it.
No, he was.
That was a
rap game
off,
will
dude.
Never
I'm
be
older
the same.
Than you guys. He was
go
out.
Go Ninja, go Ninja,
no,
go.
He was on the outs at that point.
Dude, okay, you just had five slices of pizza and like a 2 liter of Pepsi.
He was at, you know where he was at that point? He was at MC Hammer, Too Legit to Quit. Like,
awesome
where it was
song.
Like, it's about to go. It's not happening.
See, I missed
anymore.
MC. I missed Hammer. What's the math?
All right, DMB has 7 number one albums and Prince has 8.
Whoa, it's pretty much
way closer.
DMB is the White Prince.
DMB is White Prince.
He settled it, dude. He's a sex symbol.
Now, fucking John Mayer's White Prince.
Yeah.
Everyone's
yeah.
like, he's actually really good at guitar.
He is, too.
You don't understand. I'm more of a music guy. He shreds.
You
he
love his comedy, shred. Right?
I've never seen it.
You love his stand-up.
I like that he's involved in the community.
You do? You like?
I love when guys like that get involved in the community.
Is John Mayer involved in the community?
In the industry.
He does. I don't know if he still does it, does he? No, he does, because he was doing stuff with Chappelle, wasn't he?
Well, that was a while ago.
I think a long time ago.
I remember his comedy being, like, weirdly good for a guy.
Yeah, that shouldn't. That shreds.
Yeah, he does guitars. He really is an amazing guitar.
That's what everyone says.
He plays in the Grateful Dead. He was like,
I know. I've heard he's great.
Like,
I've heard Prince is
he's
the
good.
Best.
I wanted to hate him. I heard he was like a big dick.
The Dead's a band.
I was like, fuck this guy. What? Grateful Dead?
I've tried so many times the Grateful Dead. I just can't get into it.
That's fair.
Yeah.
It's kind
Fish.
Of square.
Oh.
Yeah.
I hate.
What'd you say?
Fish. It's really kind of a square.
True. You are a bit of a square.
Fish does stink. Fish stinks. Grateful Dead, they have their song. They have their hits, dude. You got to give them their hits and get away from all the crap.
I don't even know what the hits are. I know Truckin'
obviously.
And I know, I like that song.
Casey Jones, isn't that the
China
Grateful Cat Dead?
Sunflower, Casey Jones.
Casey Jones
what was the
good.
One in the 80s that came out?
Touch of Grey.
Touch of Grey, yeah, I like
classic
Touch of Grey.
Hit, yeah.
That's never a good sign. What's that one song in the entire decade?
To be fair, that was their decline. And they came out with a mega hit. And it was like, everyone was
nice.
Like, all right,
exactly, like Vanilla Ice.
Exactly.
Like, Too Legit to Quit was so nice.
That song sucks.
Too legit.
That album sucks.
Too legit to quit.
That album sucks.
Did you buy the MC Hammer second album? Like,
I got it for Christmas for my cousin. And I was like, well, it's better than
I
like,
got it for Christmas for my cousin.
Yeah.
You're funny. You're a funny guy.
You got a problem
you're
how
funny,
I talk?
You're a funny guy. No,
you got it from
I
or
like
for
the way
your
you
cousin.
Talk. It makes me laugh.
I like the way you talk.
This is a very musical
episode. This is a musical podcast. So you got it for as a gift or you were gifted?
No, he gave it to me and I was like, this is better than like some shitty sweater I would never wear.
For sure.
And I listened to it once and I was like, this sucks, man. Like, it just sucks.
Really?
Bad album.
Literally any album I got, I was like, this is the best album of all time.
Yeah.
Every single CD I ever got.
I was already heavy into
when I was a kid, I had AQUA. I was like, every song's a hit. Barbie girl.
I'm a Barbie girl.
Oh.
In the Barbie world.
What do you want me to do, dude?
They were ahead of their time.
I had two older sisters. I had no shot at music.
Man, that's a bummer, dude.
Yeah, it sucked.
They were ahead of their time, to be fair. AQUA, if AQUA came out now, everyone would be like, holy shit. They'd be billionaires in Korea right now.
Chumbawamba.
Chumbawamba, that stands up. Chumbawamba stands
up. Another smash hit album. Two one-hit wonders, and I was listening to the full album. They were like, yeah, my favorite song is not Barbie Girl. It's the fuck.
They were huge.
There's another one on there that was so nice.
Or
I forget. There was one on there that I loved.
I stand by the Venga Boys. Venga Bus is coming. Yeah. It's a good song.
What was their song?
Venga Bus is coming.
Song
rules.
Yeah, of course. Remember that? Barbie Girl still holds up.
Dude, nah. For sure.
You're crazy if you don't like Barbie
Girl.
What
was their other one? There was Barbie Girl, and they did have that other
hit.
There
was one other one that I was like, this is
good. Did you like Cotton Eye Joe?
Obviously, dude, I was in like fourth grade. You tell me again, Matt's exactly right. A couple pizzas, some fucking 2 liters are flowing. You're at a basketball court, you're sprinting. You've never been this high on sugar.
You're running in swishy pants. Yeah.
Sliding on the floor.
Kinda hard. Not, but I know. What was Aqua's other hit? Dr. Jones. What?
I'm a lot of them.
I don't remember that song.
Thanks, Sean. I think Lollipop was the one I
used to turn me on, dude.
I bet there's parts of the world where AQUA is still very popular.
Yeah, like Eastern Europe, probably.
4 million monthly listeners.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, dude.
Where are they from?
4 million.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, what? I was going to say, they're probably...
They're fucking foreign freaks?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's crazy.
Fifth grade. You're just starting to get into babes.
Dude, this is...
I am the candy man.
Yo, this was the song. This song fucking... This song fucking rules,
come
dude.
On, dude.
Dude, you gotta give it up.
You know it.
Yeah.
Da-da-da.
You
yeah,
know
I
it.
Remember this one.
That's a fucking...
Da-da-da. I knew they had that other song I fucked with heavily. Yeah. Candyman.
That crushes Sinatra's fucking gay wop.
Oh,
ass.
Insane. Insane.
I've done it all. I am.
Dude, you said gay and wop. Two derogatory terms.
Well, they're interchangeable. But.
Yeah.
All right.
Now you're getting dunked on, dude. Welcome to the podcast.
Christ. I just thought you would have learned your lesson by now using words like that.
I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this.
Fuck you, dude. Fuck you.
I don't want to do it.
Don't bump Munch over me then. If you don't all right,
we
this.
Won't bump you again. I promise.
All right.
I promise, we won't bump right.
you. It's enough.
All right. Let's
it's
get serious.
Guys, let's get serious for 1 second. Shut up about music. People listen to this podcast sure. to hear fun stories.
Do you have any food, dude?
So against hungry. All odds, no. You're never going to believe this. No, you saw me trying to microwave some pesto chicken for breakfast.
That was rough, dude.
That was a rough one.
Yeah. Then
dude, microwave broke? I've never seen that in my life.
Microwave broke?
Put it in for 2 minutes. It came out ice cold.
Who broke it?
Was there a tiny little mushroom cloud in the middle of it?
Somehow, yeah. She somehow broke the microwave.
Dude, man. She's doing the opposite of what a girlfriend's supposed to do. She's supposed to be making things with that microwave.
Yeah.
She's breaking that microwave.
Break it for good. I hate microwaves.
So that happens after you let,
I do hate microwaves.
You let women vote, and now they fucking breaking the microwave.
Next thing you know,
don't get me started.
Don't get us started on women's suffrage.
It's not too late to turn it back.
We can turn it back.
We ran the experiment.
I am the candy man. That's so
good. I kind of was into that.
Of course you were into it.
It was intense.
It was.
Yeah.
Again, imagine you just got a fucking, you got a six pack of Surge. Your parents go, you guys can each have one.
Surge.
You and your friends steal five Surges.
I was too old for Surge when it came out.
Dude, do you, I mean, to be fair, do you think that January 6th would have happened if we never let women vote?
I think I blame Surge for January 6th.
That was a lot of Surge brains.
Yeah.
Yeah. Boys got touched by Surge sure. early.
I wasn't allowed, when I was little, well, you probably remember this because I think it was more of an East Coast thing, but Jolt was the big thing.
Yeah, that was forbidden fruit.
And they wouldn't, like, my mom refused, like, I was forbidden to have it.
Exactly
yeah, so
right.
We would walk to the pizza place and we would go get that by ourselves.
Yeah. Yeah. It was wild. They bragged twice the sugar, twice the caffeine.
Yeah.
They bragged about it.
Yeah.
Like,
and it ruled.
Give it to a fucking 12-year-old.
When I
happens.
Finally did have it, it tasted like shit.
Dude, we would chug
it was
those.
So gross.
We used to chug those and go into the woods and like smoke cigarettes, and it was just the best.
We would roll up pieces of paper and smoke them.
Yeah, dude. We used to smoke sugar
packets.
Did you
guys grow up together?
No.
No, but similarly.
Similar lifestyles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Smoking shit in the woods. Just
smoking cool shit in the woods.
Smoking each other's fucking pipes.
Yo, dude, what the hell? The we didn't do that kind of shit in the woods. We looked at porn and shit. Dude, yeah.
We looked at porn.
Yeah. Yeah. All getting boners together?
Yes.
Looked at porn together, yeah. Dude. Fucking yeah. Looked at condoms in the ground. It was tight.
You didn't show your dick to your friends?
Probably.
I did nonstop. Nonstop going.
I always did it as I did it. I was big on the dick gag as a, in college as a joke.
It's very funny.
And like, I'm like, man, I can't do that anymore.
Nah. Dick, those boys gotta still be able to show dick.
What?
I could do it. I would do it to you. I wouldn't do it to like, you know, dirt. Like, there was a time where I probably would have thought like, if I met another male comic on the road, it'd be fine to do like the dick. Yeah, I'm like, yeah. I wouldn't do that now.
No.
You know?
Yeah, no.
Like,
can't,
you know,
not allowed.
What's that?
Not allowed to do that anymore.
Ari did it to me 2 days ago.
It's funny.
I knocked on his hotel door. I opened it. He was fucking ass naked.
It's always
funny. And then he tried to show me his hemorrhoided asshole. And I was like, I'm not looking.
Yeah, dude. He sent me some really bad ass pictures. They're really gross.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Yeah, I never did the dick joke. I always worry that people are going to look at my tiny flaccid penis and laugh at me.
No, you got to have a semi and be like, this is what it normally looks like. You know?
I don't want to turn around and like, then I'm out of the joke. They're just laughing at me, not with me. And I'm kind of like, fuck you guys.
Yeah. That's a risky run.
Showing your tiniest flaccid penis to your boys is the ultimate joke.
I can't do it. I'm not strong enough. Dude, if you saw my penis right now, you guys would.
Dude, that guy from the. Everyone's laughing at that guy from the Eagles thing.
So little and small right now.
Mine gets real little when it's not hard.
Yeah, mine too.
Perfectly normal.
That's how they work. Yeah. Finally, some common ground, dude.
Now we all
my
agree.
Penis gets intensely small when it's not hard.
It's weird. It's crazy.
It kind of fucking pisses me off. I'll just be hanging out and be like, no way.
Yeah, dude. I'm jealous of dudes that have like a nice flash.
Guard dogs sets all. He set off the fucking alarm again at the airport. His dick's so big, they think there's something in there.
Who?
The TSA. The TSA.
Who's
the
TSA, dude?
Who's dick?
Penis.
Guard dog is
Gardini's
huge.
Penis is so big.
Really?
Huge.
Are you serious?
It's a national security threat.
I get patted down if I wear like a hoodie. You know how they'll be like, there's just something, there's a lot of cloth right there.
Right.
They do it to his penis.
No, they don't.
Yes.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's always like a black guy that's like, I don't
want to
do
this. Your dick?
No, not when the camera's off, I'll show it to you.
Would you really? I've never seen it. I'd like to see your penis.
Oh, okay.
So demand to see his penis.
Tell him he's fired. Tell him we're not going to promote his new podcast.
You want to get ahead
we're
of
not going to promote your new podcast if you don't show us your penis.
You got to show a bunch of old men your penis.
Dude, we might be the Weinstein brothers. That'd be sick, dude. What?
I'm just laughing at what you said.
Just trying to get young boys
I'm
naked.
I'm laughing at what you said, dude.
Look at those three. Can you imagine them?
Yeah, dude. So nice. A lot of diversity at that table, dude.
Yeah, yeah. Type of weird Mexican, Italian, Indian.
Black, all colors of cock at that
black
table.
As hell. Oh, yeah.
Fuck, I want a drink right now, dude.
We're going to get a little drink afterwards.
I want to fucking get after it now, man.
Really?
We can't get after it now.
Get cold ones.
But we could have a little bit of drink and then watch. I want to watch Unchained Melody by Elvis.
Ooh.
I really want to see Fat Elvis. All right,
but let's watch it at the bar, though.
I could hit touch tunes. We could listen to it.
We can watch it on our phone at the bar. Why can't we
watch
it?
Ooh, I like that. That'd be fun.
Yeah. What's your bar around here?
There's one right
Or do you not want to
corner.
Say because it gives away your location?
I don't give a fuck. Blackbirds. There's a place called Blackbirds around the corner.
I don't like it. Is there a wiper?
You're going to like it. There's Beatles shit in there.
Yeah? Is it named after the Beatles?
I don't think, but.
They probably ran with it, yeah.
They toss one in.
Blackbirds? What kind of bar is it? I like the name.
I don't know.
Blackbirds, where it's just all black dudes' dicks.
That would be a cool bar.
What a stupid
bar. No.
We all thought it.
No, we like it. We like it. That's what we do here.
There's something so funny. It was when I saw it on It's Always Sunny, but like calling a dude's dick a bird, his bird is so funny. Like, I don't know why. It just is.
That's what we grew up calling it.
Is that a Philly thing? Yeah.
Outside of Philly, it was bird. I had a cousin who would hump the ground, like, when we were little, and his dad would come in and be like, Dr. Ennis is going to put a needle in your bird if you keep doing that. Like, dead serious. Dr. Ennis is going to put a needle in your bird.
Yeah, he pulled his birdie out. You know.
Where are we at? Let's switch over to the Patreon so then we can go to the bar. We're at 54. Let's keep it rolling for a couple minutes, then we'll switch over.
You guys, actually, I have a very hot topic. Did you hear about the case of the lawyer who might have murdered his family?
Yeah.
And they're trying to prove he did, and it's like nobody really knows if he did it or not. But he's getting in trouble. Like, so he did steal money from his law firm. He was addicted to oxycodone. And then he lied about something else. But the whole trial, he's like, I did do all these things. But
I'm sorry. Lemaire already farted. Lemaire's already disrupting the pod. Day one, you're over there shitting your fucking trousers.
So stinky, dude.
So,
it's a fun case to follow. Because he might, it's like.
I was wrong. I was thinking, who's that Musburg guy or whatever?
Is that
him? I think it's him. Does he have two sons?
No, it was a wife and a son.
Are they killed?
Yes.
But I think he has another son.
He does
son.
Have two sons.
Yes, I have a question. Yeah. Do you only shoot with that one camera?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
God, I love how like bare bones it is. Seriously.
Yeah, everybody else sinks all their bullshit into production. You don't have to do it.
Yeah. I'm going to start a podcast.
What is it?
Fuck.
I don't want to say.
Well, no, I'd like to hear it, please.
No.
Well, we're going to go back to this guy killing people because that's fun.
I want to hear the podcast.
I
do want to hear your
pod. This is awesome. Fuck this guy and his family. It's like a lot more affordable than I thought it would be.
What's your pod?
I don't want to say yet because I want to wait till I launch it.
What's the name of it?
I have two different names. My first podcast ever was called Down with Joe DeRosa, and I was going to call it that again. But I might just, I have a different name that I might change it to. But the other name pigeonholes me a little more.
What's the other name?
I don't want to say.
Come on, brother.
Yeah.
All right, fine.
I'll tell you off camera.
All right, fine. So this guy, dude, you've been watching. I saw a clip of him like crying and being like, I would never.
That's his whole thing. He's like, dude, I am addicted to oxycodone. I did steal money. I feel bad about that. And they're asking why he does oxycodone. He goes, because it makes things fun and more interesting. Dude, so far he's being honest about everything.
Telling the truth.
He's like, I didn't kill my family, though. And he's a lawyer, so he's hitting them all with lawyer speak. He's like, I know without a shadow of a doubt that I did not kill my family. They're like, were you there that day? He's like, absolutely not. And like, here's cell phone footage of you there. He's like, I mean, yeah, obviously it's my house. I stopped by for a little bit, but then I took off. And it looks like they're going to get him.
That makes sense, though. If somebody was like, were you in your house that day? I'd be like, no. But it's like, I was there for like a minute.
Yeah.
If you're out all day, you're not like, I was at home.
He went and visited his mom.
If I leave the house,
you'd ever murder somebody?
No.
If you had to, though, it would have.
What if you had to?
If you could picture, let me rephrase that. Not if you had to. What's the scenario where you think most likely you could murder somebody?
I mean, like the least amount of thing to like murder? Like what's like, the I'm minimum like, threshold?
Like, okay, so in my head, I'm like, okay, I don't think I'd ever murder somebody, but I'm like, if I was in traffic and for some reason I had access to a gun, that's the thing where
it's
I'm
probably
like,
the closest.
Oh, it could potentially pop off.
It could escalate, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like somebody being an asshole, like, you know, like that's the, you know, so what's your.
I could spaz. I spaz in a fight, in a fist fight.
And just.
I could spaz. I could cry and spaz.
And beat a dude like to death?
Accidentally, yeah. Keep going.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's the clip. But I would never do that.
What about an intruder at nighttime in your
house? I would never carry a gun in the car or shoot somebody.
Intruder at nighttime?
Yeah, would you kill a guy in your house at nighttime if he
was in there? I'd be such a fucking pussy if somebody broke into my house.
Get out!
I'd come out and be like, I scream at him, run out, be like, what are you doing in here?
So he jumps into the bed on you.
If he hops in bed?
Hops in bed, what's going down?
Depends what we're talking. Is he hopping in just in the middle, just snuggle?
He's reaching.
If he opens
reaching.
The door and says, guys, I feel sick, can I sleep in your room?
This is why I could never own a gun, dude. Because if I owned a gun, I would be full on in I wish your motherfucker would mode. Like I'd be like, I can't wait for somebody to break in this fucking house.
That's the whole point. He's fucking
I'm so close to buying a cool gun.
Really?
I'm very close. I look it up constantly.
I want one bad.
It's called an MPX.
Can you guys have anything here in New York? Do they let you have?
I think you can. I rifle? Think it takes a lot. You could have Yeah, you can get a handgun here.
Oh, that's cool.
I think
about just getting a BB gun, like just like in case somebody does break into my house.
Pepper them up, yeah.
Pepper them up, then they run away or something.
No, you gotta.
Dude, you shoot a guy in the face with a BB gun, that dude's not coming at you anymore.
He loses his eye.
I think he's going to be pissed off, dude.
Well, how many pumps? How many pumps would you give
like,
him?
Ow!
Yeah.
Would you 10 pump each shot?
If somebody's breaking into your house and is not afraid of confrontation physically, they're taking a BB gun to the face.
Yeah.
If somebody breaks in your house and you're like, "Hey, get out of here!" and they're typically going to run, right?
You might as well do a paintball.
But if they're like,
at that point.
"I'm staying," it's you or me. I'm taking your whatever,
your ass.
I might make it.
It's time for me to fuck your girlfriend and take your Xbox.
I might make a spike bat.
No.
I might build a spike bat and keep it under my bed just in case.
Ooh.
Yeah. Hopefully mankind doesn't break in. probably is, you know, a hardcore match. That's going to put you through a fucking table.
Hopefully his tag team partners out there get you.
That's what they always say, though, about knives and bats and shit like that. Like, if the guy gets it away from you, you're in trouble. Like, a gun, the guy's not going to get it away.
Then you have another knife in your boot.
True. While you go, I don't want any problems.
You wait till you're an inch from death and you go right in his neck.
Yeah.
And the camera pans away and reveals that you got him.
It's pretty funny.
What's that? I was pretending to fling cum at you.
Oh, okay. A cum?
Yeah.
That's a good weapon.
Yeah. I was just, for some reason, you come out of the back room.
You come out of your bedroom and just throw jizz at a guy.
You keep cum hands at the ready while you're sleeping. Yeah.
Remember in Silence of the Lambs when the guy throws cum in her face?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
I watched it on the plane the other day. I forgot about that part.
So people watch everything. I've seen people watching shit on planes, like full out sex scenes. I'm always like, Jesus Christ.
I know, it's very weird.
Take it easy.
Yeah.
Pig DiStefano just texted me. Dude, he just texted me a picture of a shopping center called the Barnyard. That's so that's funny awesome. That I said Pig DiStefano just texted me, and that's what he sent me.
He's shopping at the Barnyard.
Yeah, he said he's out in Reno.
I haven't seen him in a while.
Ooh.
I like him. I like when I see
love
him.
Chris.
He's awesome.
I love Chris. He's one of my favorite people.
He's a good guy to be around.
Yeah, he's a good dude. He's a good dude.
Let's switch over.
Yeah, why don't we switch to the Patreon?
Switch to the Patreon. Guys, check out, and by the way, your podcast with Sal. I love it.
Yeah, it's great.
Thank you.
I tell you all the time, but those clips of you guys arguing, Taste Buds is so fucking funny.
Thank you, buddy. Can I plug my dates?
Yeah, of course.
I have dates coming up. I'm doing a big run in Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and New Orleans. I don't remember the name of every venue off the top of my head, but I know Howlin' Wolf is the one in New Orleans. And then I go right from there to South by Southwest to also do my new hour there. I'm doing that on the following Tuesday. And then I got my Crane Theater residency here in New York with my hour. The next one's on March 22nd. And then I'm going out to Chicago and that area for a big run late March into April. So go to joederosainfo.com, get all your tickets and your show info. Please come out. And if you're in New York, I have a bar and sandwich shop called Joey Rose's.
So good.
7 days a week, joeyrosesnyc.com.
And look, I know it's a fun bit, especially if you're like a Legion of Skanks fan, to be like, fuck Joe. Go see him do stand-up.
The Skanks are so supportive. Honestly, the Skanks fans are so supportive.
I know. But I'm saying, go see Joe do stand-up, and you'll.
Thanks, man.
You're going to go to your room and tear down the Marilyn Manson poster. And you go, everything I knew was a lie. You fucking...
I'm putting fingers back on my gloves.
What the hell? Yeah. Matt, you got any cool dates?
Yeah, Stress Factory, I think Hartford, Connecticut, and then Stress Factory, New Brunswick in March. And there's Boston. There's a bunch. Austin. Just go to mattmccusker.com/dates. DATES.
And
please, for the love of God.
A whole bunch of, we're going to release the next quarter of shows coming up. So I don't know. I don't even know when they are yet. Yeah. They'll tell me soon.
They'll be coming.
They'll be coming right at you.
Yeah, be ready.
Thank you. Join the Patreon. What the hell is your problem?
Yeah, that's the real
one. I'm going to for real fight Derosa on the Patreon.
Yeah.
I don't think you should, dude. I'll hand you your fucking ass.